Hello everybody, I'm back. I finished my project that I made my last video about reborning Pretty in Pink, Ashton Drake Pretty in Pink, the 25th anniversary. And I also have a box opening video, you know, that gives a little history of why I purchased her, etc. And I don't want to go into that now. So if I am technologically smart enough, I will leave the link for that video up on this video too. And the one that I did just previous showing, saying that I was going to reborn her. So, yes, I did. So I'm just going to get started showing some of her details to you. And as you can see, she's on a cloth body. This was her previous body, just showing you. It was very interesting. It's not, it feels jointed, but it's not. There was no weight. There's no weighting in this body. The only weight that was involved with this doll was in her head. And her head is heavy enough, but there was no weight in the body, no weight in the legs, no weight in the limbs, so she was very light, and that did bother me, because my other Ashton Drake dolls, in particular my silicone, is not like that. They have some weight to them, and I can't have my other reborns that I have. I weighted them pretty heavy, and I might have to go back in now and take out some of that weighting because it bothers my arms. I mean, they're heavy. It's heavy now, and I'm getting old. So, anyway, but this was what it looked like, was this body. So, anyway, what was interesting was disassembling her. I had heard from other artists on YouTube that had taken apart Ashton Drake babies, that one of them was having a struggle because after she cut the tie, first off, getting into the tie, they closed this up incredibly well. I mean, to protect her, because you know how annoying it is having that little thing stick out. It can scratch you. Anyway, they would hot glue this rim to the neck rim there, so that the head didn't fall off or this wouldn't break or whatever. And they did that to all of the places where they put cables in. So when I started taking her apart, it took me a while to get into the back, as you can see, to get the zip tie out. But and I thought at first that they hot glued it, and I thought, oh no, this is going to be a challenge. But they didn't, thank goodness. But what they did do is I got started taking the cable out, and they had, I pulled it all out here. They see these little strings? They sewed it in to the rims on the all of the limbs and the head. They sewed it in like four places around so that it wasn't hot glued, and it was so that it wouldn't come off. But these were kind of a pain in the neck, but you cut through them, and then they finally came out and they were fine. So it just took a little bit, and as soon as I figured out that that's what it was, the sewing, I got her apart very quickly. And then I realized that she had no weighting. And so I took her apart and I started painting her limbs. Now, this was another little challenge, but somebody had warned me about this on YouTube as well. The paint, the vinyl is so soft for Ashton Drake. I mean, want to pull over one of my Ashton Drake dolls and show you. This vinyl is so soft, and it's almost slick, as you can see. And it's, I don't want to call it oily, but it's slick. That the paint, the Genesis Heat Set paint, will not stick to that slick vinyl. So you needed to matte varnish her first. And then the paint adhered very nicely. So that's exactly what I did. I matte varnished all her limbs, and I didn't touch her manicure because that really was pretty good. And so I varnished all the limbs and the head, and then I just painted them like I would be doing a reborn. Only thing I didn't do was I didn't remove any paint. She had barely any blushing, anything. She was very, very white vinyl. So that kind of made it easy. All I did was add color and creases and a little mottling. So I'm gonna try to show you that on her arms and her legs. You can see, you know, I added a little color on the elbows, and it's not coming out as quite as dark as it is really in this camera, but she has creases on her hands, which are really tough. You can see she has creases. Can I show it better? Oh no. And she has creases on her hands. I did the creases and I did the red, and I mottled around and did all her creases on her arms. And you can see some mottling there. And you know, the creases up here, creases, everything, and the dimples in her hands. You can see that, I think. So, and the same with this arm. You can see, and then the legs. I'm going to get the legs a little bit better down here. See if you can, maybe that one you can see better. I don't use a phone, because if I used a phone, you guys would be seasick. And then I put it on a tripod, it just doesn't come out. So I'm using my Panasonic 35 millimeter camera all the time for my videos. So it's stable on tripod. I wish it could show the color a little bit better, because that's really quite light compared to what it is. But you can see the creases that I did, creases, and I blushed the heels, and I blushed the top of her little pads on her feet, and did the top foot, and I did the creases up here and on her toes, all the mottling on this, and the blushing on her knees. And I did that, and like I said, this isn't showing very well because of, I mean, it's just not very dark, but she's even looks a lot darker here in this video than she actually did on other videos prior to this. And then I moved on to her head, and her head was the most challenging. She has such a cute face, and I didn't, you know, want to overdo it, but I did her cheeks, and I repainted her lips, and I shaded inside her nose and on that little crease down below her nose, and I did the creases on her eyes for them to stand out. I didn't touch the eyebrows, put some little stork bites. Did a little tiny bit of modeling. You can't really see it on there, but her chin, her cheeks, and I did her little ears so that they have some color on it. And after I got done with that, I matted. I did a blue wash, and that always helps to bring some coolness to the color. And then I matted it all, and I actually had to do two mattings because the vinyl, I said, it just wasn't going to not shine through this. So I ended up doing two mattings, and the second one seemed to work pretty well. It's still maybe a little shiny on her arms, I don't know. And then the body, after I got it all done, you know, I thought I was going to have to wait till today or Monday to get her body. So I had ordered one. Well, I was digging around, making sure I had enough zip ties for everything. Even though bodies do come with the zip ties, sometimes I don't like the zip ties that they come with. So I found a body. In fact, I found two. Two that I had stashed away. One was 21 inches. One was 20 inches. So I chose the 20 inches to see how that would work, and I had the 21 to back it up. And so this is a 20 inch body. I like it. It's a doe suede. It has the ruching here. It has, you know, I like this because it has the, oh, you're not even seeing that. Okay, let's go down here. Let's back out some. And it has the panel in here, and it's a piece of fuzz. The panel, and it's that just makes it look nice on the doll, not blobby. And she has ruching on the bottom, on her bottom. And so this one, though, I was surprised. I hadn't realized it because I don't normally ever get jointed bodies. I just don't like the way they look. But this one is jointed, and it was a different brand than the other jointed ones that I've seen that has the device. Oh, I don't even know how to say it. The device stuck in there. This is different. The device is actually, you know, really well hidden in there. And so I went with the jointed. It looked like it was going to work out really good. And I know that you're probably wondering, what are these flaps that are sticking out? Now, this brand of body, which I did not bother because I was so excited, I did not bother to look at the brand, which I wish I would have, because I really believe I got this body from Dolls by Sandy. She does have great bodies. And this, so this might be, I'm not sure if it's an Adri Stope body, because Sandy sells a lot of Adri Stope products, but this has this little flap, and what it's for is to come over here and protect you from getting scratched by the end of the cable ties, and that is a nice addition. And it has it on every limb and the back of the head that has a cable zip tie attachment, and I'm assuming that they would glue these down and then you wouldn't see them. Well, I don't want to put glue on the body, so I just left them like this for how they are now, because like I said, I'm really excited to get her dressed. And so I'm going to go in and just zip with thread, just slip stitch it closed on all of them. It won't take long, but I can get around here and all that. So we're just going to leave it like that for now today. And then tonight, maybe I'll just thread my needle and slip stitch all of them. Anyway, so I'm trying to think what else I did. Oh, this. She never turned her head. She couldn't turn her head in this body. I mean, some of my Ashton Drake, like my Alexa here, she has a little panel because she's posable. She has the panel down here, and her head can rotate. Well, I thought it could. Yeah, it rotates. It's just you have to practice with it a little bit, you know, but she can move her head and, you know, just loosen it up. But I don't want to put a ring, you know, that's what you can do as a reborn artist. You can put a ring in there on the head so that it does turn. But I have a secret that I learned years ago that the same stuff you use, Eileen's paper glaze, when you that you use on the lips and all that, it on that groove there where you attach the zip tie in the neck, if you take the Eileen paper glaze and you just put a nice coat of that inside around that little groove there, all around it, let it dry, you know, for half hour. Then you put attach her head, and then she moves her head very nicely, and you don't have to put any paper glaze. So I'm excited because now my girl can move her head. Okay, so now people have, you know, I've had people knowing I'm doing this and saying, well, what do you do with the hair? Oh my gosh, you know, are you going to burn the hair up? No, and I've done a lot of dolls where I've had to remat them, and I explained that before. And I always cover up their head really well with one of these baby caps. Now, don't ever be tempted to put a plastic saran wrap on the head, or one anything like that that's plastic, because that you really are taking a risk of melting that plastic right onto the head, or it starts sweating and all. But this, oh, and before I remove the hat, I was, you know, I was prepared at first to take out her hair. It is rooted in, but look. Listen to this if you can hear this. I think you can't. That's how hard her head is. Her limbs are soft. If her head or face had been like that, that'd be a whole nother story. So no, I wasn't going to pull her hair out or use an air or anything like that to remove it and think that I was going to root some more hair in there. I use a fine needle anyway, but even a 38G needle, it would have broke. You just couldn't have never got it in. So I just left her hair, and it's not that bad, and we're going to fix it up. But there she is, just with her hair from the cap and all of that. So we're excited. So now that I've shown you the revamp, which I am, and I think I have some pictures of her before that I'm going to attach to the end of this video. If I can do that, guys. Anyway, and so I always usually put cloth diapers on my babies, but you know what? I didn't have an extra one, and I found one from another doll, and it just looks so bulky. I said, forget it until I can order some new ones. I'm just going to use the diaper that Ashton Drake had on her. So, now there's a bow. Okay, we're going to just put in her little diaper. And and see these diapers, they're doll diapers, I know, but they fit really well. So, she has her diaper on. I'm going to turn her little head to face you while we're getting her dressed. Yeah. Okay, Missy. So, I chose today to put on this next outfit that I got last year. And I know, and it's getting to be springtime here. Still, there's a little bit of a chill in the air, but not bad. It's been even hot, and then it cooled off. But this is the next outfit that you can't get now, but it's just darling, and it has hand embroidery on it, which is really nice. I love that. And has little pants to go with it. So we're going to put her in this. We'll start with the pants, and this is their, I believe, 3 month size, if I'm not mistaken. Or, up to 1 month. So this is their smaller size, but it just looks big to me. So I don't know. Oh, I have fuzz from her body that keeps flying out and getting everywhere. So, okay, here we go. I'm going to put her in these little shorts. And I wish, of course, that she was full limb, because that just makes changing them so nice. You can get such nice little outfits. And I have quite a few full limb babies, but with the Ashton Drake, they're 3/4 limbs. And maybe they'll get the message and do 1/4. I mean, not 1/4. They already did that. But full limbs. Okay. I really am going to get these pants on this doll. Okay, here we go. Oh, that looks cute already. And I don't want her to be so chubby that, you know, they look weird. So, anyway, okay. Now, she does have the 3/4 arms, so this is going to stick out a little bit, but I have something to stop that. And I would have put but I think this will work just fine. Oh, she looks so pretty in this. Honestly. Oh, this fits her perfect. Okay, let's just zip you up here. Oh, and her arm. That's the thing about the jointed arms is they tend to sometimes rotate all over the place. Okay. And here's the buttons again. I'm not going to bother with that one. Okay, let's see you. Oh, yes, that looks very cute. We could get away with not even having to cover up those arms, I think. But this has a little sweater to go with it, and it's just adorable. So I have a chance to use that. It has little flowers embroidered on the front all around and a little collar. So it goes with this outfit. We're going to put your little sweater on, Missy. I mean, she's not even the same doll. I mean, it was so exciting. She's perfectly weighted now. It was just fun. My husband even mentioned, he goes, "You're just having a great time with this, aren't you?" And I'm like, "Yes, I am." It's been a while since I've actually reborn a doll, so I didn't want to have to be rooting hair anyway. So this was a lot of fun. Put her, and this has little wooden faux wooden buttons. Okay, now I'm going to show you another trick for the hair. See, that this is one of the reasons I don't like jointed bodies, because they get all twisted up like this one is. So who knows, maybe the body that will be coming in January and Monday or wherever it is when it gets here, we may end up doing that. But yes, okay. Now we just need to get her in the sweater into this. Okay, well, that is not a plus for them, because the arms can get very wonky. So, and this one is still a little wonky, so we're going to have to really work on that. As you know, put this much work into a doll to find out. So I'm going to wait to do my slip stitching on those things until I get the other body, and we're going to see how that one works. Okay, well, there she is with her little sweater on and her pretty little dress for next. that goes with her pretty little eyes. So now you're going, oh my gosh, but is this going to be the Ashton Drake head? Let's see that the hair, you know, gets bad. And, you know, I appreciate that they rooted in. That makes it nice. But this Carol's Daughter hair milk is wonderful. Refresher spray. I've had this bottle for a while, but when you need to refresh your doll's head and their hair, and especially like this with the Ashton Drake hair, that is very dry right now. It's years old, and it needs it. You just spray it all over, get it in there. This spray-on conditioner. And the great thing about her is she doesn't have any bald spots, any hair missing in certain places. So, take a brush, of course, and some of it you may need to respray a little. Like this. Just a bit. Okay. And, you know, somebody, you know, mentioned to me something. Oh, she looks like a boy. No, this is how my hair was as a baby, how my daughter Elizabeth's hair was as a baby. She had quite a bit of hair on top of her head for a baby, but it wasn't long. And it started growing out. She had these short little bangs. So I need to wipe this out. But you can see her hair just came right down. Looks nice. You can use water too, of course, to do this. But if you need the conditioning, I suggest, you know, because this is a leave-on, and it will be wonderful for your doll and help to restore that dryness. I even think she needs a little bit more there. And you can do cute things with it. It's almost like a gel, too. You can, you know, try to create a curl or whatever you need to do. Okay, there she is. There we go. And I'm going to put this on her. Her little head. That'll keep her hair in place too. And okay. There we go. There she is, ladies and gents. Who's ever watching? There is the rebirth of Molly from Ashton Drake, and this is 28 minutes long, so I hope you will endure this. And please leave a comment, please subscribe, like, all of that good stuff. And you know, I'm getting my feet wet again with YouTube and getting more in the groove, and I pray I will do my best to bring you some good content. But I thought this one was good. So any of you that are considering reborning a Ashton Drake doll, go for it. It's a lot of fun, and the rewards are great. Okay, thank you.